Recently, NVIDIA announced Cosmos, a world foundation model platform that accelerates development of physical AI applications like humanoid robots and autonomous vehicles. Hi, I'm Mehran Maghoumi. In just 5 minutes, I'll show you how to get started with the Cosmos Diffusion text-to-world model. I'll show you how to generate your own videos using your own text prompts, and then how to customize this model on your own data for subject-driven generation using the NeMo framework. The Cosmos World Foundation models are available for you to try at build.nvidia.com. You can try the autoregressive model for predicting future video frames based on an input image or video. You can also try the diffusion models to generate videos from images or text prompts. All these models are available for you to download and use on any accelerated platform. In order to get started with these models locally, you'll need access to the NVIDIA container registry through an API key. If you do not have an account, you can create one at ngc.nvidia.com to obtain an API key. You would also need to have a valid Hugging Face API key for downloading the Cosmos models as well as other dependencies. Everything else that you'll need to get started is available in the Cosmos GitHub repository. Let's go over to the command line and see what the process looks like. The first thing we'll need to do is to log into the NVIDIA container registry. For the username, we'll use $OAuth token, and for the password, we'll paste in our API key. After authenticating with the container registry, we'll clone the Cosmos Git repository and change our working directory. Next, we'll create an environment variable called hf_token that holds our Hugging Face API key. Now we are ready to start the Cosmos NeMo container by running the following Docker command. This command sets up the environment and the paths that we'll later need and starts the container. Once we are in the container shell, we'll change our working directory to Cosmos. Let's start by downloading the Cosmos diffusion models by running the download script as shown here. This will take some time. Now let's try to generate a video from a text prompt using the Cosmos Diffusion 7B text-to-world model. To do this, we'll need a single NVIDIA GPU with 80 GB of video memory. We'll create a couple of environment variables. The first one specifies that we'll use a single GPU for inference. The second one specifies our text-to-video prompt. Here, we are prompting the model to generate a video of a teal-colored robot working in the kitchen. Next, we'll input the inference command. This command specifies the model we are running the inference with, the text prompt, as well as the file name for the generated video. This command will take some time to execute. Let's take a look at the video that we just generated. You'll see that the model used its own internal knowledge of what a teal robot would look like to generate this video. Next, I'll show you how to customize this model on your own data for subject-driven video generation. Using a collection of videos of a specific subject, we can adapt this model to generate videos of that subject in new environments. Keep in mind that post-training this model requires 8 NVIDIA GPUs with 80 GB of memory. You can use NVIDIA NeMo Curator to process your data, which facilitates the creation of semantically meaningful clips for post-training. If you do not wish to use NeMo Curator, feel free to skip ahead, where I'll show you how to do post-training using a sample dataset that we've provided for you. To process your data using NeMo Curator, navigate to the Cosmos Data Curation Jupyter Notebook at this path. Ensure that you meet the minimum hardware requirements, then set up the Curator command line interface. Let's start by setting up the required environment variables by running this cell. Run the next cell to download the sample dataset from Hugging Face. This sample dataset contains a few video clips which we'll use for subject-driven generation. Let's look at one of the clips that we just downloaded. In this clip, we see the teal robot working in a kitchen. The teal robot will be the reference subject for subject-driven generation after post-training. Next, we'll set up our Hugging Face credentials and proceed to downloading the models needed for running data curation. NeMo Curator uses these models to analyze your video files and create semantically consistent clips. The next cell shows you how to clip your video files and caption them. But for our purposes, I'll run the following cell to clip my videos without captioning. We specify the path to our input videos as well as the output path to use for saving the results. We are also specifying the use of the fixed stride splitting algorithm with a stride of 5 seconds. This instructs NeMo Curator to take our input data and generate a multitude of semantically meaningful 5-second long video clips. This will take a minute to complete. Afterwards, the results will be available in the output path that we specified. You can use these clips for following along, so long as you set the raw data environment variable to point to this path. Let's go over to the command line again. If you did not use NeMo Curator, you can download the sample dataset I showed you earlier through the command line. Simply run this command to download the data locally. Before we can start post-training, we need to pre-process our video files and generate embeddings for them using the Cosmos tokenizer. We start by defining an environment variable that points to the video clips we intend to use. We define another environment variable to specify where to save the embeddings and then run the prepared dataset script as shown here. To run this script, we specify the text prompt to use for generating the embeddings. Note the use of the special token SKS in the prompt. This token specifies the name of the subject that we'd like our model to know about and helps it generate subject-driven videos after post-training. We additionally specify the number of chunks to sample from each video, which determines how many training samples we'll have in the embeddings. Keep in mind that higher numbers mean more training samples, but also longer training times, so adjust this value based on your needs. If you are using the clips produced by NeMo Curator, I recommend setting the setting to something between 10 and 50. Let's run the script to get the embeddings from the Cosmos tokenizer. Depending on the number of chunks you specify, this will take some time to complete. We now have everything needed to start the training process. We continue by defining the number of GPUs available in an environment variable and start the training script, where we use a small learning rate to run the script for 1,000 steps, which should be sufficient for our purposes. Once training completes, we can use our original text prompt and generate a video after the model has learned about the teal robot in post-training. This procedure is the same as I demonstrated earlier. Let's take a look at our generated video. Here's a side-by-side comparison of the videos that we generated before and after post-training. This video demonstrates our model's newly refined understanding of the teal robot to deliver a visually compelling and contextually accurate result. And that's it! A quick look at customizing and running inference with the Cosmos diffusion model. Get started now with the resources in the description.